Sai Baba, a personification of spiritual perfection and an epitome of compassion, lived in Shirdi, a little village in the state of Maharashtra, for 60 years. Sai Baba's perfection, purity, benevolence, detachment, compassion, and other virtues evoked deep reverence from the people around him. With a view to ending such communal differences, Baba wanted to show through his miracles the truth and that he was the supreme master of all beings. For him, there was no difference between caste and creed. His religion was common to all, which was that spiritual wisdom is not something received from others. It has to blossom from within. Each one has to develop the faith by his own efforts. Those lacking such faith make themselves remote from God. Their own actions account for such lack of faith. These are the words of Baba. In the 19th century, in the Nizam's Maharaj dominion, there was a remote village called Patri. In that village, there lived a couple named Ganga Bhavadya and Devagiri Amma. They had no children. In answer to their prayers, a son was born on September 28, 1835. That child was Sai Baba. As Ganga Bhavatya developed a feeling of total detachment and renunciation, he decided to retire to a forest. Devagiri Amma, who looked upon her husband as God, decided to follow him, leaving the child behind to be looked after by Sufi fakir, who also happened to be childless. He took charge of Sai Baba and brought him up in his home. The boy stayed in the fakir's home for 4 years. After a few years, the fakir passed away. Fakir's wife took care of the child well. But Sai's behavior was different from others, and this worried the fakir's wife. He used to visit a Hindu temple and sing songs in praise of Allah. The Hindus used to tease the boy for his misbehavior. He would enter a mosque and declare, "Rama is God and Shiva is Allah." Members belonging to both the communities went to Fakir's wife and complained about the boy's behavior. Unable to deal with the situation, Fakir's wife handed over the boy to a pious scholar named Venkusa, who lived near her house. Venkusa was extremely fond of the boy. In every matter, he used to give priority to young Baba's views. Seeing this, in course of time, members of the ashram developed envy towards the boy. One night in 1851, the boy left the ashram. Reached Shirdi, a very small village at that time. From then on, he lived in Shirdi. He sat under a neem tree and he used to crush its leaves. Many people used to visit him for their illness and sorrows. He used to give them the medicated neem leaves and they would get cured. At that time, in Maharashtra, there lived a person called Sathe. He was a collector then. His wife passed away and he was in great grief, unable to do anything. His friend Natke visited him.
How long will you be like this? You must move out of this place. It will distract you from your present sufferings.
I am not able to move from here.
If you go on like this, you too will die. Come with me. I will take you to a sage who lives in Shirdi. He will solve your problem.
Sathe agreed and they went to Shirdi and met Sai Baba. Sai Baba was laughing and was very casual.
Is he a sage or an eccentric?
Don't worry about anything. Bodies are like water bubbles. Don't develop any attachment to the body. Develop your attachment to the spirit within. Worries are passing clouds. Have courage. Protect your child. On hearing Baba's words, Sathe realized that Baba was not a crazy person, but a great saint, one who knew the past, the present, and the future. Sathe was the first to realize that there was no proper amenities at Shirdi for Baba's followers. He provided residential accommodation for visitors in Shirdi, called Sathe Wada. Sathe was the first to set up apartments at Shirdi. Sathe became very close to Sai Baba. As the days passed, the residents of Shirdi developed hatred towards Sathe because he was collecting all the offerings to Baba for building a temple. Just at that time, a silver chariot with silver horses, which was in Sathe's keeping, was stolen. Sathe was the principal trustee. The people of Shirdi suspected Sathe of complicity in the theft. One day, one of the residents planned to strike Sathe with an axe on the way. Getting wind of this, his maternal uncle called Sathe and urged him to leave immediately as it was too dangerous for him to stay there. He told Sathe that he could worship Baba from anywhere. He need not be in Shirdi to do that. Reluctantly, Sathe left Shirdi.
Baba was absent after the departure of Sati. After a few days, a couple with a school-going boy named Shyam came to Baba. Shyam took to Baba instantly. He saw Baba sleeping on the wooden plank in the night. One day,
Swami, you don't seem to sleep at all at nights. You are laughing to yourself or talking. What is the secret of all this?
Dear child, there are many people who are praying to me and I am speaking to all of them. When I turn my finger, I am turning their minds. When I laugh, I am amused.
Swami, my classes don't take up much of my time. Let me stay with you during the rest of the time and serve you.
I bless you, my child. Shyam grew up and became very close to Sai Baba. He used to take care of everything from his food to his bed. One day, some people came to visit Sai Baba. Who are you, young men? We are your disciples. I have no disciples in this world. I have countless devotees. You do not recognize the distinction between a disciple and a devotee. Anyone can be a devotee, but that is not the case with a disciple. A disciple is one who carries implicitly the commands of the Guru. Shyam was listening to everything. He felt that all these years, he did not have any other thought other than Sai Baba. Baba called Shyam. Shyam, in this entire world, for me, you are the only disciple. All the others are only devotees. Shyam, with tears in his eyes, fell at the feet of Baba.
My Lord, you alone are my refuge.
Shyam breathed his last at the feet of Baba. Baba had never shed a tear in the presence of devotees. When Shyam passed away, he shed 3 drops of tears.
Swami, why do you feel so grieved? Everything is in your hands.
Dear boys, I am not grieving at all. Almost all his sins have been wiped out already. By the 3 drops I shed, the remaining sins of Shyam have been washed away.